close contacts allows us to resolve bilateral issues and develop a mutual approach to resolving key international issues. Today we have discussed a very urgent situation in the Syrian province of Idlib. Since the beginning of this year, militants acting in this province have activated, and they have done a lot of damage to the civilians. Militants have continued their attacks on the Russian Khmeimim air base. Once again, they attempted to use missiles and shelling against it. There have been at least 15 attacks on Khmeimim since the start of this year, and each time, in real time, we informed our Turkish counterparts of that. In fact, the militants were able to restart hostilities. Unfortunately, Turkish troops have also being killed, and this regard I've expressed my condolences to Mr. Erdogan, and I've expressed my condolences to the entire Turkish people. We do not always agree with everything with regards to our Syrian partners, but in every critical moment, we base our actions on a high level of our bilateral ties, and we were always able to find some mutual understanding and develop and come up with solutions. And we were able to do the same thing today. We have reaffirmed that both of our countries are interested in continuing our work within the Astana format. It is the Astana process that boosted Syrian political process. And today's meeting was preceded by work by several consultations of different delegations on the situation in the Idlib zone, and both our countries believe that we need to preserve the sovereignty and territorial integrity of Syria. We are convinced that we cannot stop fighting international terrorism. And following the results of our meeting, we formed a came up with a document that will be presented by our foreign ministers. The document speaks of decisions that myself and Mr. Erdogan have come up with over our talks. I hope that these agreements will help create the foundation to find a way towards de-escalation in Idlib, in Syria, and will help prevent a humanitarian crisis, and will create conditions to continue the peace process in the Syrian Arab Republic between all the parties involved. I'd like to thank Mr. Erdogan. I thank him for coming to Moscow and for reaffirming the status of our relations. I'd like to thank all of our Turkish colleagues for this difficult but very constructive work, which resulted very positively. Thank you.
I would like to thank Mr. Putin, ministers, media, ladies and gentlemen. Like to express my deepest respect for everyone, and like to thank Mr. Putin for inviting me for a meeting. We see that these tensions persist, and it's good to have had this meeting. Today, we pay special attention to Syria and to the recent developments in the province of Idlib. As Vladimir Putin said, we spent over 6 hours talking over this issue. I can say that we had a very frank conversation, and we discussed every issue on the agenda. As you know, relations between Turkey and Russia go deep into history. We have over 500 years of history that we share, and between our peoples there are very close relations, traditions. What we would like to do is to continue our cooperation on the principles of mutual respect. This year we're celebrating the 100th anniversary of establishing diplomatic relations, and we invited Vladimir Putin to visit Turkey on that occasion. As you know, in 2018, in September, Vladimir Putin and I reached an agreement. We signed the Sochi Memorandum, agreeing upon the situation in Idlib. We agreed to alleviate tensions, and we agreed that there will be no attacks launched in that region, starting with May. More and more attacks started to appear, and that was the reason why we believe the agreement was violated. That was its violation. The responsibility lies with the regime's forces. They violated the agreement. 4 million people live in that region, and these 4 million people are not terrorists, but they are bombed nonetheless. We don't think this is acceptable. The people, the refugees, they are fleeing their homes because of these attacks. According to the data from the UN, around 1.5 million people are now right on the border of Turkey. Syria government wants to wipe out the people in that region and drive refugees to the territory of Turkey. And we will not stand idly by. There is a lot of tension. We installed our observation posts in the province of Idlib. These posts were there to control and monitor the ceasefire. Some time ago, Russia and Turkey agreed to send reinforcements in order to stabilize the situation on the ground, to stop attacks from happening. To prevent the regime from attacking, we had to act proactively. We applied every necessary measure to maintain dialogue with Russia. Because of the many attacks coming from the regime, we've experienced a number of problems. That is why we had to change the status of our operation. Today, we discuss this issue with our Russian colleagues. Cooperation between Turkey and Russia today is at a very high level. This is what allowed us to reach agreement. We also discussed the situation to the east of Euphrates. We agreed to work even closer on Syria. I believe that relations with Russia will not be damaged by the situation. Today, At the negotiating table, we discussed this crisis, and we exercised our political will to achieve common ground. We will be implementing ceasefire, and we will be coordinating a number of steps. This night, starting from midnight, this very midnight, we will be establishing ceasefire in order to make this regime last. We are ready to make every necessary step. What we need to do is not to further deteriorate the humanitarian crisis. We will do our best to help the people in need in Syria. We will also do everything within our power to help the refugees to come back to their homes. Those people who had to flee because of the attacks, our foreign ministers will be reading out the joint statement that we agreed upon. Turkey retains the right to respond to any attacks on the part of Syria. My dear friend, Putin and I, we will maintain dialogue on this issue, and there will be dialogue between the ministries. As for this crisis, we will continue working together. We will respect Syria's territorial integrity and sovereignty, because what we want to do is to settle this issue. We'll stand by the Sochi agreement. The only way to solve this problem is to ensure lasting peace, stability, as per the Geneva negotiating process. Thank you very much, and I do hope, and I am sure that this meeting of ours will be a major contribution to the process. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be reading out the Russian text of the joint statement. Additional protocol to the memorandum on the stabilization of the situation in the province of Idlib as of September 17th. Turkey and Russia, the guarantors of the ceasefire in Syria, relying on the memorandum on de-escalation zones signed in May 4, 2017 and the Idlib de-escalation zone agreement signed in September 2018 reconfirmed their commitment to respecting the territorial integrity and sovereignty of Syria. We are determined to fight terrorism and eradicate all terrorist groups recognized as such by the UN Security Council, and we agree that there should be no threat to civil infrastructure or civilians. There is no reason to try to justify such efforts. A political process should be launched. It should be Syrian-owned, Syrian-led process, relying on the help of the UN, according to the Resolution 2254. We need to highlight the fact that the situation should not be going downwards. The crisis should be prevented. We should help the civilians without any preconditions, without any discrimination. We need to prevent people from being displaced and relocated. We need to help people to come back, both refugees and internally displaced persons within Syria. We agree to do the following: to stop all hostilities along the existing line of contact starting with midnight March the 6th, to create a corridor of security 6 kilometers wide to the south and to the north of the M4 highway. As for the parameters and modalities, they are to be coordinated between the ministries of defense, and they will do that in 7 days. Joint patrols will be launched across along the M4 highway from the settlement of Tumba to the settlement of Ailin Ham. Additional protocol will be enacted right now. It's signed today. It has been written and translated in Russian, Turkish, and English. It has been signed by ministries of defense as well.
Foreign
ministers of Turkey and Russia will be reading out the joint statement.
Suriye Arap Cumhuriyeti'nde gerginliği azaltma bölgeleri oluşturulmasına ilişkin 4 Mayıs 2017 tarihli muhtıra ve İdlib gerginliği azaltma bölgesindeki durumun istikrarlaştırılmasına ilişkin 17 Eylül 2018 tarihli muhtırayı hatırda tutarak Suriye Arap Cumhuriyeti'nin egemenliğine, bağımsızlığına, birliğine ve toprak bütünlüğüne olan kuvvetli taahhütlerini yineleyerek terörizmin tüm tezahürleriyle mücadeleyle Birleşmiş Milletler Güvenlik Konseyi tarafından terörist olarak tanımlanan tüm grupların ortadan kaldırılması yönündeki kararlılıklarını yinelerken, sivillerin ve sivil altyapının hedef alınmasının hiçbir şekilde mazur görülmeyeceğini kabul ederek, Suriye İtilafı'nın askeri çözümünün olamayacağının ve İtilafın yalnızca Suriyelilerin öncülüğünde ve sahipliğinde, Birleşmiş Milletler'in kolaylaştırıcılığında Birleşmiş Milletler Güvenlik Konseyi'nin 2254 sayılı kararıyla uyumlu siyasi süreç yoluyla sona erdirilebileceğinin altını çizerek, insani krizin daha da kötüleşmesinin önlenmesinin, sivillerin korunmasının, ihtiyaç sahibi tüm Suriyelilere ön koşulsuz ve ayrım gözetmeksizin koruma ve insani yardım sağlanmasının, keza ülke içinden yerinden edilmelerin önlenmesiyle, mültecilerin ve ülke içinde yerinden edilen kişilerin güvenli ve gönüllü olarak Suriye'deki asıl ikamet yerlerine geri dönüşlerinin kolaylaştırılmasının önemini vurgulayarak aşağıdaki hususlarda mutabık kalmışlardır. 1. İdlib gerginliği azaltma bölgesindeki temas hattı boyunca tüm askeri faaliyetler, 6 Mart 2020 tarihinde saat 00:01'den itibaren durdurulacaktır. 2. M4 karayolunun kuzeyinde 6 kilometre ve güneyinde 6 kilometre derinliğinde bir güvenli koridor tesis edilecektir. Güvenli koridorun işleyişine dair ayrıntılı esas ve usuller, Türkiye Cumhuriyeti ve Rusya Federasyonu Savunma Bakanlıkları arasında 7 gün içinde kararlaştırılacaktır. 3. Türk-Rus ortak devriyeleri 15 Mart 2020 tarihinde M4 karayolunun Turumba'dan Aynal Havra'ya kadar olan kesimi boyunca başlatılacaktır. İş bu protokol imzalandığı anda yürürlüğe girer. Türkçe, Rusça ve İngilizce 3 örnek olarak ve eşit yasal geçerliliği olacak şekilde 5 Mart 2020 tarihinde Moskova'da imzalanmıştır.
First, and then.